What's going on, everybody? This is your host, Voodoo Priest Man. In this video, I want to talk to you about shoe magic. For you guys to actually like to stir up a little bit of something, whether it comes to love, whether it comes to dominance, whether it comes to destroying somebody, whether it comes to whatever it is that you want to do. But before I go in and I go hams with this video, what I would like for you to do is I would like for you to subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed yet, and make sure that you hit the notification so that way you can get all the updates from my upcoming videos. And the reason why I wanted to do this video is because to me it's very interesting when you can create magic, and especially when you're dealing with shoe work. Like, you know what I'm saying? We all wear shoes. I mean, and for you people who are feet fanatics, you know what I'm saying? I'm not a feet fanatic. You know what I'm saying? I hate feet. You know what I'm saying? Don't put your feet by me. You know what I'm saying? We good. But now when it comes to shoe work, I'm going to make sure that I put your name in my shoes. You know what I'm saying? So you good. So all I'm saying is this though. Anything that you're gonna do on the right is for love. Anything in the right that you're gonna use is for control, is for dominance. So what you do is, I'm always telling people to go ahead and use a red pen every time you're gonna write magic, or you use a number two pencil with no eraser, and you actually gonna write in the inside of the shoe, not in the outside, but you're gonna write in the inside. So it's gonna be kind of challenging, but that's what you're gonna do. So what you're going to do is you're gonna write the name of a person in the right shoe if you want to dominate them, if you want to have control of them, if you want them to love you, if you want them to go crazy over you. So you can use oils too if you want to be creative. And you wanna use oils, you can use oils too. So you go ahead and you write their name, you write like a little petition of what it is that you want, and you put all your intentions in what you're doing. So you write it, and what you write with the red pen, with the two pencil, you're gonna write what it is that you want. Not much, but just get straight to the point. I wanna dominate such and such. I want such and such to actually go crazy over me. And what you're gonna do, I want my such and such person to actually just come to me. And you're gonna write them, you're gonna put a little bit of oils, you're gonna wear them. Voila, this is gonna be for your right shoe. Or if you wanna dominate them, if you wanna get a job, you can also put it in your right shoe, and you can put the name of the person, and what you do is you put it on there. Like, you know what I'm saying? The reason why I want you to do it in the inside, outside the shoe, because some people, they rather do it in the outside of the shoe. And I'm gonna tell you the difference. When you do it in the outside of the shoe, your foot is not touching the magic. You want your skin or your sock, you know, that is close to your socks or whatever, to touch the magic that you're doing within, so it can manifest, you know, it can manifest faster. That's the way that I do it. If you want to put a little bit of cayenne pepper and you want to sprinkle it there a little bit, just that makes things quicker, you could do that. Now, if somebody messing with you, somebody trying to create some type of chaos, you write their name on the left shoe. This is for to destroy them. You also gonna write not what you want, but you're gonna tell the spirit, and you're gonna ask the universe to actually take control of them, to control them, so that way they can get away from you. And whatever the situation might be, somebody messing with you at your job or anything by that nature. Or I'm gonna tell you a little bit more of what you can do when you have access to somebody else's shoes. But if you don't have access to this person's shoe, whether you want somebody out of your job, you don't want to deal with them anymore. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna write it on the left side. You're not gonna put no good oils, you know, you're not gonna put no dominance oil, but you can, you know, get away oil or anything that has to do about people actually just going or destroying them. You know what I mean? And just write it on the left. What you can do with any of your shoes, you can sprinkle a little bit of white salt, and what that does, that brings protection, so you can be protected from anything negative that can happen anywhere. So that's what you do. You can sprinkle a little bit of in your shoes. You don't have to write anything. You can just do it without intentions. Of course, you want to have those intentions in place, and you want to make sure that you understand that that's just for protection. Now, if you have somebody else's shoes, the only thing that I'm going to tell you to do, if you want to protect them, you can sprinkle a little bit of salt, you know what I mean, in their shoes. If you love them, you want to put oils for them so they have good luck and things like that. Because a lot of these people, they don't believe in magic, so you want to help the magic come to them. Now, if you're with somebody that is pissing you off, somebody that is cheating on you, somebody that is doing things to you, and you feel that you want to let the universe tell you whether this person is cheating on you or not, and you want to know, what you do is you sprinkle black salt in their shoes, And from that point on, you're gonna see what's gonna happen. That person, if you really wanna get rid of them, that's what you do. You sprinkle the black salt and they will get away. Difference between black salt and white salt. White salt is for protection. Black salt is for somebody to actually go away. Don't put black salt in your shoes. Put it in their shoes. If you want to get rid of them, you don't love them no more, you don't know what to do, they get on your nerves, you do that. Or to talk to the universe to bring events to happen so that way the spirit can show you if they're doing things to you or not so they can get away. You put black salt in their shoes, okay? I hope you understand now how you can work with magic with shoes or somebody else's shoes. Make sure, once again, if you're not following me here, you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, once again, make sure that you subscribe. And also, I want to hear what you have to say. Make sure you give me a like, a share, and a comment. And also, make sure that you follow me on my Instagram, that I'll be kicking it over there a lot, at Voodoo Priest Man, and to also hang out at my Facebook group, which is also Voodoo Priest Man. Go ahead, get your shoes ready, get the ingredients ready. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Let's do some magic. On to the next one. Your boy, Voodoo Priest Man. Psh.